So, you know, last Friday, I drove down to Champaign County here in Ohio, a small town called Urbana. It was the home of Michael Farms. That's not his name, that's the name of the farms, the Michael family, a 3,000 acre supplier of fresh produce and vegetables who had nearly 90 employees. And making them one of the largest in the region. Recently, this farm had experienced a COVID-19 outbreak with nearly 40% of their farm workers COVID positive. As we know from the effect of many meat processing plants, even across the country and especially even in Ohio, hit with COVID-related closures like in Salem and Winesburg, Canton, large food growers and producers are sort of highly susceptible to this deadly pandemic, with many days of production halted and the sad reality of dozens of deaths reported. Then I went to Justin and Becky Tilly from Tilly Farmstead, who supplies Clintonville, Ohio market down there by Columbus. I visited them about a month ago, and they said that they're hoping to earn just one third of their average annual income while doing their best locally. You know, here in Ohio, here in Springfield, where I live, I love our Clark's produce and Pendleton's, where I couldn't wait to go get the corn and, you know, after it harvested, and stock up on the pole beans. My favorite here in Springfield is it's called Soup, right? The Springfield Urban, Ohio Urban Plant Folk, who my colleague and ecological food justice activist, Dr. Sarah Fortner, hit me to. In the face of COVID-related challenges, they meet the needs of a food desert on the south side of here where I live in Springfield, Ohio, a neighborhood overwhelmingly African-American with fresh produce on a weekly basis at a market or less than market prices. Unfortunately, we see this in Toledo, East Cleveland, West Dayton, Youngstown, and more. Food insecurity is a real issue, both in our state as well as nationally. But unless we meet these injustices head on with an intentional eye upon all our citizens, we will continue to fall adrift and not fulfill sort of the best of what it means to be in Ohio. You know, we are in crisis with long lines for food boxes and a dire need for more food support through SNAP programs and others. We should know without a doubt that our economy must be grounded in the principle that food security is domestic security. And domestic and global food supply chains are vital to agricultural production. We are out here arguing about masks, as I just was talking about. Folk are out here dying, food costs are soaring, debt are amassing across our nation, for what? And so we need to handle this COVID crisis. That means that, as I just talked about, our local farmers, especially the small ones, need access to credit, right? Bigger supply contracts and safe infrastructure to stabilize the farm economy, especially in light of our current and future COVID-19 challenges. You know, the current and future aftershocks of COVID-19 slowly positions us to parallel the depths of, as taken from sort of the big economic disruptions of the past, you know, like the Depression of 29, the recession of 08. But policy decisions made today will have similarly long-lasting repercussions. Though I'm glad Ohio has strong Democratic leadership in our state legislature, led by Representative Amelia Sykes and others, I am also worried that its Republican majority might not learn from these past disruptions and inadvertently push through policies that would stifle innovation and cultural production. You know, as I think about it, small businesses and small business development is also important to me. When I think about homes and communities across America that COVID-19 has brought out the sort of the improvisational energies of so many people, weekly, I go to food trucks and I see the boom in food trucks, the making and supplying of masks. Community business development is very important to me. Working with area foundations, chambers of commerce, and big business to ensure that underrepresented populations are supported and invested in is of the utmost concern to me. But what does business post-COVID look like? Unfortunately, due to poor national leadership and individual people taking libertarian stances of personal freedoms while slowly but surely thwarting our ability to sort of get to the other side of this pandemic, why should I wear a mask? We just have no idea when COVID-19 will subside. Meanwhile, across our nation, and no more than here in Ohio, from Youngstown to Shaker Heights, from Lima to Trotwood, from Cincinnati to Cleveland, our small businesses, and especially minority-owned businesses, are suffering record layoffs, closed doors, limited access to federal paycheck protection program. You know that PPP that never got to me. All that has reduced so many businesses to a shell of itself just last year. And so we think about what 2022 might look like. I am concerned about equity within small businesses, the presence of over-leveraged collateral, and our much-needed entrepreneurs' ability to restock and rehire and rebuild. What would bonding processes look like post-COVID? Who we are as a nation, and especially for us in Ohio, depends on these small businesses. And this is what is also on my mind. I'm a fan of block grants. And when done with intentionality and robust community support, an immediately value hike sort of occurs in these communities. And not only do our neighborhoods look better, but our neighborhoods feel better, our children engage better, and our core, and of course, sort of our home values perform better. Neighborhood by neighborhood, city to township, to incorporated cities, how we come out of COVID-19 is going to take some sweat equity. Our state house must invest in our resiliency. Budgetarily, we can't appropriate our way out of economic recovery. I'm sorry, we can't do that. We got to grind our way out. Everybody must have a chance to work. We must invest in 15 and 16 year olds and their virility, teaching them how to earn, how to bank, how to reinvest in themselves through an expansion of youth job corps and programs like that. We must put the R back in the ODRC, the Ohio Department of Rehabilitation and Corrections. And our rehabilitation of ex-offenders must be robust and expand to what I like to call, quoting a ludicrous, release therapy, preparing minds, bodies, and hands to be productive citizens. I applaud places like Edwin's Restaurant in Shaker Heights, Ohio, whose intentional efforts at hiring ex-offenders highlights the very best of what business visionaries are. I've eaten in many prisons as I speak regularly, and places like Marion and Chillicothe have excellent chefs who are on the inside. If they have been running the laundry room in the ODRC, why can't they run the laundry room at the Hilton Corporation or Columbus Blue Jacket Stadium? If they have been cleaning floors for 5 or 10 years, you gonna tell me that a university can't hire an ex-offender to join the janitorial staff? Look, we have to put our money where our mouth is, Ohio. Post-COVID demands that everybody gets dirty and works our way through this rut. Roads to neighborhood housing here in Springfield. I'm excited to watch neighborhood development take place. Organizations like Ms. Tisa talked about, in Conscious Connect and others. are revitalizing our South Side communities as an investment into the soul of its citizens. It's happening all across Ohio, but we need it to happen because we are better as a nation. When we see the best in each other and we effort toward human capacity building and human potential. And so, on this 19th day of August, I am making an announcement. I'm announcing that I want to take on a larger role of service to my state and to my country. I want to meet the challenge of forging and expanding a path for Ohio that will ultimately be a national benchmark. Good news is, it's not solely my good looks that will help me achieve that goal. It is you, Ohio, and all those friends of mine across the country and the world who support my endeavors. You 11 million plus Ohioans who are resilient, visionary, and service oriented. You who span the gamut of being global leaders in agriculture and education and business and industry, as well as hardworking farmers and assembly persons and manufacturing workers and construction workers and truckers. You brilliant artists. Friends of mine like Archie Green and Honey Bell Bay in Cleveland. The Ohio Conservatory Ballet's Enos DeBrovia, I love her in Akron. Talented scholars and progressive thinking community engaged citizens like Deja Demons in Dayton or Julian Mack and Anna Tony in Toledo. Congresswoman Fudge and Representative Howes in Cleveland and organizations like the Northeast Ohio Black Health Coalition. Pastor Todd Johnson and Pastor Lou Macklin over there in Mahoning Valley, I see you. With your talent, with your support and your vision linked, aligned and linked with mine, we can navigate Ohio out of COVID-19 into a brighter future. Ohio, will you help me? Will you help us actualize our potential? You know, all of my friends nationally, internationally, will you take this journey with me? What journey you want to know that I'm asking you to take with me? Well, let's watch the video.
Hi, my name is Julius Bailey, and I'm poised to become the next governor of this great state of Ohio. I'm seeking an exploratory committee across Ohio to get an idea if what I envision and what you desire, my fellow Ohioans, are truly aligned. Let's make one thing clear. I'm not a politician. I'm an educator. I'm a community organizer, a team-oriented leader who recognizes the talents of all around me as being crucial to winning. I don't promise what I cannot deliver, and I don't destroy that which I cannot rebuild. This potential run is not just about me. It's about all of us. It's about all of us whose potential is untapped, whose opportunity seems to have hit a wall, and whose hope in tomorrow is fleeting. The urgency of our challenges, the continued opportunity to serve and lead a team of 11 million people to do great things is what led me to make the decision to seek your support. We as a state deserve better, and I know Ohioans want better. Our schools are competitive in some parts across the state, but struggling in others. We can do better in Ohio. An economy that was flourishing in Columbus with rebuilding efforts in downtown areas like Akron and Dayton and Springfield and others, they're positive steps, but incomplete because we're leaving many of our other cities' neighborhoods behind. Bailey 2022 is about access. It's about belief and competency. We're positioned to be a state where we model how community and law enforcement can work together in an effort to recognize the humanity of each person. Yes, I unapologetically affirm that Black Lives Matter, and as such, this understanding only sustains what makes us great as Ohioans. We are going to keep this exploration process simple. I urge you to get to know me. Invite me on a Zoom call. Bring me to your homes. As socially distanced, of course. Exchange a few tweets. Let's take a gentle walk on our beautiful Ohio parks. Again, we're going to keep this long journey simple. It's all about ABCs. We must prepare to act, dare to believe, and create our tomorrow today.
Hold up, Doc. You about to run for governor of Ohio and win 2022?
Well, I just feel that we just have to do it. You know, the time
yes.
is right. I think the nation is experiencing the kind of climate that right. it needs somebody like me. And so that's why I want to run for governor. But you know what? For me, you know, audience, you know, the truth is that, you know, I could have run for anything. I could have stayed in my comfortable job. But for me, to understand what it means to be the leader of this great state, it boils down to ABC, right? It's about access. You know, I want to make sure that every school in Ohio improves. That would be my goal, to sort of resurrect that which is dissipating and dying, and to keep strong those who are flourishing. 2- and 3-tier sort of education is simply unjust and does nothing to motivate and kickstart the dreams of our youth. And it fails to create and sustain a viable workforce. So that's A. B is belief. The governor's job is executive. Yes, but it's also visionary. And I am that kind of leader, one that makes sure citizens believe in their tomorrow and believe that their tomorrow will be better than their today. They believe that home ownership provides long-term family security and believe that their government is not simply bureaucratic, but effective and empathetic to the needs of all people. And then C. Create. Creation, innovation, birthing, rebirthing is what a Bailey State House would represent. I would do all that I can to lay the foundation for ideas to flourish, potential to be actualized, and creators to dream and produce, to collaborate, and also to innovate. This is what I say the best of what Ohio is, and why I am the optimal candidate for this position. You know, this might be the most unrealistic goal that I've ever set for in my life. Ohio is a state where the African-American population is sort of dwindling. And I need to be a voice for not only my people, but all across the state, as I mentioned, farmers and workers and ex-offenders, as well as small business owners, and helping to set the vision for big business to understand how to link themselves, get their hands dirty with the rest. Politically, last election, Richard Cordray ran a strong race in 2018. He amassed over, 2 million votes? The first Democrat to ever do it and still lose the election. Ohio is a tough state for us Democrats, but I believe in the soul of the people. I will let the pollsters do their work while I go out and meet all of you in our 88 counties. If you can dare to envision it, we Ohio can make history happen. So take down my information again. You saw it on the video. Bailey2022.com is my website. Go there, sign up, see how you can help. You gotta help me to reach all 88 counties, all 11 million people. My goal is 3 million voters. 3 million, how do I get there? Well, it starts with you. If today you can share my page, tell somebody about it. Schedule a Zoom call with your friends, your organization, your church. Invite me up to your towns. I got plenty of masks to wear. Let's sit down and discuss what I have to offer for this state and see if I'm the kind of leader that you want to represent you. So again, that's Bailey2022.com. I'm also on Facebook and Twitter at Bailey2022. Go there right now. Like the page on Facebook, Bailey2022. Follow me on Twitter, Bailey2022. And tell your friends, follow this guy. Let's watch this guy. Even if you're critical right now, which you should be. Of course, people who've been a part of my life, people who I've impacted, people who I've worked for, people who I've raised up, and people who I've supported, they fired up, ready to go with me. But some of you are just saying, who is this Julius Bailey guy? Well, let's get to know one another. If you say, this is my relationship with you. Let's do this sort of political dance where I move, you move, yeah, just like that. We can do this. Our future together is then as easy as ABC. Let's act, because we believe that we can create Ohio's tomorrow today. Ms. Tisa, are you going to support me?
What? Hold up. Do you see this?
I didn't see that. What's that?
You know, just a little baby.
You got gear already? Carol. We got swag. You got one for me and a 3 or 4X? Oh, I mean, that's good. You got one for me?
Do I?
Wait a minute. And I got the swag. Hey. Betty 22, y'all.
I thank you for watching today's show and season one. Remember, season two will reconvene on Monday, September 7th, which is Labor Day. And wow, you just witnessed a major shift taking place in my life. I look forward to all of you joining Bailey 2022. Obviously, only Ohioans can vote, but you all can help me. In a couple of months, I will have to ask you for your financial support to keep things rolling. But until then, all I ask is for you to help me to get my word out. Like me on Facebook and Twitter at Bailey2022. Hit up my website at www.bailey2022.com. Tell an Ohio friend or family member about me. Help spread the ABCs of this campaign. Thank you. Take care. Stay strong and stay safe. Take two. I thank all of you for watching today's show and the entire season one. Remember, season two will reconvene on Monday, September 7th, which is Labor Day. Oh, wow. You all just witnessed a major shift taking place in my life. I look forward to all of you joining Bailey. Dang it. Take two. Repeat. I thank... Repeat, take two. I thank you for watching today's show and season one. Remember, season two will reconvene on Monday, September 7th, which is Labor Day. And wow, you just witnessed a major shift taking place in my life. I look forward to all of you joining Bailey 2022. Obviously, only Ohioans can vote, but you all can help me. In a couple months, I will have to ask you for your financial support to help keep things rolling. But until then, all I ask for is for you to help me get my word out. Like me on Facebook and Twitter at Bailey2022. Hit up my website, www.bailey2022.com. Tell an Ohio friend or family member about me. Help spread the ABCs of this campaign. I thank you for everything you've done for Straight No Chaser, and I look forward to working with you again. Take care, stay strong, stay safe.